I think it was August 1974, September, I received a letter from the secretary of the MRC enjoining me not to do any of these experiments because of the moratorium, which was very easy to obey because I suddenly realized the great merit of something I had discovered very early, which is the difference between chastity and impotence. So we didn't have to be chaste, we were impotent to do anything. So of course we could agree to the moratorium immediately. But I could see that in fact this needed to be got into the work. However, we lived in a time now where these things had to be handled very carefully. In this country, we set up the Ashby Commission, and I gave evidence to the Ashby Commission, and I had the chance to look at my evidence again a few months ago, because I felt quite certain that I'd remembered saying something which people denied, but of course it is there. What I predicted, that nobody would be cloning all these genes, they would be synthesizing them. And I predicted that, in fact, people would synthesize the gene for insulin. And the gene for insulin would be put into a plasmid and it would be produced as a thing. Now, that was pooh-poohed at the time because, you see, it raised the question which no one was willing to ask about, was if your gene carries the danger from the organism that it comes from, what the hell is an insulin gene, a synthetic insulin gene? It's a piece of chemistry. So you have to dissociate the biology in that case from what you're talking about.